Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be making a video about K-pop title tracks. Basically, I'm just going to go through my least favorite title track and my favorite title track from each group. So, I want to put one thing out there really quickly. If your favorite group or soloist didn't make it on the list, it's because I haven't listened to them enough or I just don't know enough of their title tracks in order to really judge. Also, I didn't listen to every group's every single title track for this video, so if there's a group that may have a worse or better title track that I haven't heard yet, that's gonna be why. Also, if a group literally only has one title track, like if they just debuted like Secret Number, then I won't be including them because obviously the best and worst song would be the same song. So, also, this is just my personal opinion, favorite and least favorite, and I'm gonna go down the list of the groups and start with 21. My least favorite song, I don't care. So, yeah, I don't really like the chorus. It's kind of annoying. I don't like the way she goes, I don't care. And as Dare to Be would say, I don't care for this song. I don't really have much else to add to that. My favorite 21 title track is Missing You. I absolutely love how much of a gut punch this song is. I also really love Lonely and Come Back Home, but Missing You, I had to go with Missing You as my absolute favorite. 3Yi. DMT Do My Thing is 3Yi's debut song, and no, I don't think it's bad. I actually don't really mind the song at all, and I'll listen to it, but it's just that their other title tracks, in my opinion, are better, like Yes Sir and Queen. And as much as I love Queen, my favorite title track is OMM, Out of My Mind. Again, I just really love the dark vibe and concept of this song, and it sounds cool. Next group is 4MINUTE with Hadashu. That's my least favorite. Now, this was their debut song, and basically, my only opinion on this song is that it has not held up well. It's not terrible, but it has not held up well, in my opinion. Next, we have my favorite 4MINUTE track, which is Crazy. This was close for me between Crazy and Hate because I enjoy both of them, but I think I like Crazy just a little bit more. I love how hard this song goes. It's got a great EDM vibe and flavor. It's really enjoyable. Next group is Ace, with Savage as my least favorite. I don't really like this song because it's got this kind of brassy, annoying drop. Kind of like a lot of YG songs. It kind of does sound like a YG song, but I really think this is not Ace's full potential. I don't like this try-hard hip-hop thing Ace is trying to do here. Kind of like GOT7 when they made Hard Carry. My favorite track is Undercover. And oh my god, I love the rock vibe of this song. Now, I definitely don't stand this group, but oh my god, songs like this make me want to stand. But yeah, I don't really have much else to say about that. Undercover is a masterpiece. Next up is Alexa, with Villain as my least favorite title track. She only has 3, Bomb, Dear, Die, and Villain. And I do like Villain, but just out of the 3, it's probably the one I care about the least. Then we have my favorite, which is Do or Die. As much as I like Bomb, I think Do or Die has much tighter production comparatively. This has honestly just been a bop for me all year, so. Queen Alexa. Next is A-Pink, with Mr. Chu being my least favorite. This is just a very cutesy song, and it's not my favorite. Again, not horrible, but not my favorite either. I don't really know what else to say. I don't really stand A-Pink or like that many of their songs, to be honest. They're just not really my thing. My favorite is definitely Dundrum. This song came out this year and it's such a freaking bop. I absolutely love this song and I've not gotten sick of it yet. This is honestly just such an enjoyable song, I don't know what else to say. Next group is April with Oh My Mistake is my least favorite song. Again, not a group I really like all that much, style-wise. And I don't hate this song, it's just not really my style. My favorite is La 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 La. And this song certainly reminds me of Dundrum a little bit. And this is also very good. I love how forceful it is. Out. This song is good. Next group is ASTRO with Knock is my least favorite song. I haven't listened to this many songs by this group, But Knock definitely didn't make me interested in them. The song's just kind of boring and loud to me. There's nothing really amazing about it. My favorite song is Crazy Sexy Cool, though. I really like this one. It's super catchy. I love the slick R&B vibe of the song. Next group is a tease, my least favorite song being Wave. Now, again, I don't hate this song. It's honestly a summer bop, but it's far from my favorite. And this is just by far the one I listen to the least out of their title tracks. My favorite title track, Close Call Here But Answer. Absolutely love the anthem swell of this chorus. I don't really know what else to say. Inception is also a fucking amazing. That song just came out, and I also love Wonderland and Hala Hala, so honestly, it's a good group, but I really need to stand. Next artist is Bacon. Only has two of his own title tracks. Candy is my least favorite. I don't hate the song, but I don't really like the production. It's kind of weak. And my favorite is Unvisited. I really love the R&B, steamy, sexy vibe of a song like this. I always joke that this should have been on 50 Shades, but no, I really like this song. Next group is Big Bang. We Like to Party is my least favorite. And no, I don't hate this song. Just the chorus makes me think of Beverly Hills by Weezer. My favorite song was Very Hard, but I can't even lie to myself at this point. It's Bang Bang Bang. Yes, I like this more than Fantastic Baby, and I can't even lie to myself anymore. As much as I love Fantastic Baby, something about Bang 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 just really gets me hyped. I'm not sure why. I love Fantastic Baby, and in terms of Big Bang, there were honestly so many songs I could have gone with. Loser, Sober, How Do, Love Song. There's literally so many songs I could have gone with, but I went with Bang 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 just because it's such a bop. And I really enjoy it. Next group is Blackpink. Kill This Love is my least favorite title track. I think I've expressed my distaste for this song multiple times. I definitely don't hate it, but it's far from my favorite. And no, this isn't my least favorite Blackpink song, that would be See You Later. But yeah, title tracks, Kill This Love, definitely is my least favorite. My favorite is Do-Do-Do-Do, we already knew this. After 2 years, this still hasn't gotten old. This song ages like wine, honestly. It's still a bop. Next group is The Boys, with Reveal is my least favorite. Again, I don't really listen to them all that much. And again, I do enjoy the song, but it's not amazing. But I really like No Air. I really like how the song sounds. It's got a nice, fresh vibe to it. Next group is BTS with No is my least favorite. I've talked about this before, I'm not really a fan of the production at all. That high-pitched synth on the chorus. It's got this weird, epic sound to it. I get the message and what they're going for, but the sound of the song just doesn't do it for me. My favorite BTS title track is obviously Fake Love. I've talked about this before, it's literally just like one of my favorite songs ever. Just, what else can I really say? Everything about Fake Love just checks out for me. I don't understand people who don't like this song, like seriously, y'all have no taste. Next group is Bandit with Hocus Pocus is my least favorite. This is another debut song and it's just kind of mediocre. I don't hate it, but I don't love it either. Again, this song is just kind of okay to me. Then we have Dumb by Bandit as my favorite. I like Jungle as well, but Dumb is definitely my favorite here. It's a super catchy song. Next one is Cherry Bullet with their recent song Aloha Oe as my least favorite. Again, not bad, but nothing really special. And Hands Up as my favorite. I do really like the sounding concept of the song. It's got a catchy vibe to it. All in all, I haven't been super impressed with Cherry Bullet, I'll be honest. Next group is soloist is Chunga. Why Don't You Know is my least favorite. This does have a pretty basic kind of summer style to it, and this was Chunga's solo debut. I like this song a lot, but just compared to our other songs, it's not as good. My favorite is Stay Tonight. This song is just immaculate, and everything about it I love. I really genuinely think this is an amazing song and think we're sleeping on it. Next we have Signature with Asa. That's my least favorite. Signature literally only have two songs, so I like both of them. I just prefer Nunu Nana over Asasa. Asa is still a good song though. I like the beat, but Nunu Nana is just super cute and fun to me. I could see people not liking this, but I really enjoy it. It's super fun and catchy. What can I really say? Next we have CL as a soloist and Lifted as my least favorite track. this was her English debut, and it's not bad, but it's not great either. And we have Hello Bitch, which is my favorite title from her. Now, I don't really know how to count her new songs as titles or not, because it was an independent project that she all got, you know, stuff from. If I had, was going to pick a song, I would pick one and only from that project. Also, I can't wait for her comeback. Seriously, CL, come on, release something already. High Heels, CLC, my least favorite CLC song. Again, far from bad, but just not memorable to me. Comparatively, I really preferred Pepe over High Heels. I don't know. High Heels just is kind of there for me. Favorite song was a hard choice between Me, Devil, No, and Hobgoblin, but I ended up going with Me. In my opinion, it's basically the better version of 4 Minutes Hate. A little less bitter and a little more empowering, and it just sounds better in my opinion. But yeah, I could see people not liking this song too, but I really enjoy it. Next we have Day 6, with Zombie as my least favorite title track to date. I don't hate this at all, in fact I think the lyrics are really relatable, but just musically this doesn't really do much for me. Then we have my favorite, You Were Beautiful. This is a sad song and I love it, I'm a sucker for this type of thing. Now, other Day 6 songs that I really like are Sweet Chaos and Shoot Me, but You Were Beautiful really just hits different. Then we have Dreamcatcher. And honestly, all of their title tracks are masterpieces, but Fly High, if I had to choose, is my least favorite of their Korean titles. Again, this song is still a masterpiece. It was between this and What for me, but I do think I prefer What, with the exception of them yelling What, What, What. My favorite title track is very hard for me to choose, but I think I'm gonna go with You and I. Basically, I really could have gone with Pee-wee, Deja Vu, Scream, or Goodnight in this exact spot, but I ended up going with You and I. This is just a kick-ass metal song, what can I really say? This chorus is amazing. Also, stream Boca on the 17th, guys. Dreamcatcher's coming back. Then we have Everglow and Dun Dun as my least favorite. Honestly, literally all three of their title tracks are in my top 100 K-pop songs, and which does keep changing, but I'm pretty sure this specific aspect won't. I absolutely adore Dun Dun, I just, out of the three, it's my least favorite, but again, I still fucking adore it. And Adios is my favorite. Again, I adore all of their title tracks. Really, picking a least favorite is fucking stupid when it comes to Everglow. All three of their title tracks are fantastic. Then we have EXID with Ah Yeah as my least favorite. This song is absolutely fine, but it's literally just up and down again, except less memorable and iconic. Now, Up and Down still is my favorite EXID song. This is just such an iconic piece of music. I do really like some of their other songs too. I Love You is catchy, and Me and You is also a fun song, but I gotta give it to Up and Down. This will forever be iconic. Then we have EXO with Power is my least favorite title. The reason this is here is because I find the song to be really generic and kind of boring. It's mainly an EDM song. It's kind of generic to me. I think Wolf is objectively worse, but at least I get some sort of ironic enjoyment out of it. Whereas Power just bores me. Favorite EXO title track will always be Monster. I don't think anything's gonna beat Monster anytime soon. It's just amazing. I will admit that Obsession came close. I really love Obsession, but Monster is kind of on its own level, if I'm gonna be honest here. Next group is FX, and I'm honestly gonna say La Tata is their worst title track. Now, y'all are probably wondering what the heck. New album grew on me a lot, and Chu is a cute song. Now, La Tata is far from bad, but as their debut, it's not really anything special, and there is that iconic performance of them performing it in the rain, but again, FX don't really have bad title songs, so by saying it's their worst, that's not really saying much. Favorite title from FX, Rum Pum Pum. It used to be Electric Shock, and then it was Red Light, and then it was Four Walls, and now it's Rum Pum Pum. What can I really say? This group is just amazing. New album's creeping up on it, though. As weird as that song is. But yeah, Rum Pum Pum has immaculate production, a great vibe and concept, and it just is a great song to listen to. Next we have G-Idol, or Idol, because the G is silent. Now I have Dum Dee Dum Dee, which is their recent comeback, as my least favorite title track. Which again, this is another group that I don't want to say anything is least favorite. It was between this one and Senorita for which one ranks in the bottom. They're both absolute summer bops, but not as remarkable as the other songs. Like Han or Uh-Oh, which is just a freaking bop, and songs like Lion, which are just anthemic. But yeah, Dum Dee Dum Dee and Senorita are both good in my opinion. I think I like Senorita just a little bit more, but these are both still like 8 out of 10 songs. I don't have any bad title tracks, and my favorite is Oh My God, Narrowly. I really love how this song sounds. I say narrowly because I absolutely adore Latata. Latata is such a good song, but I think I like Oh My God just a little bit more than Latata. It's got a different concept and I enjoy that. I really love the concept of this song. Next one is G-Dragon as a soloist, and my least favorite being Crayon. This isn't bad. I don't think any of his songs are bad. But this is probably my least favorite and the most annoying. Favorite, it was a choice between Coup d'Etat and Untitled 2014, but I ended up going with Untitled 2014. Because this song is just such an emotional gut puncher. I really do love Coup d'Etat though. Check it out if you haven't. Then we have G-Friend, my least favorite song being Sunny Summer. This is just kind of a really unremarkable upbeat summer song to me. I don't like it, I don't hate it. It just kind of exists to me. Ironic that my favorite song is also about summer. This one is Summer Rain. This one's a lot sadder and the melancholic vibe can really sell for me. It was definitely a close call for me between Apple, their recent comeback, which is absolutely slaps, Time for the Moon Knight, which is sentimental for me, and of course, Summer Rain, which is just a sentimental song in general. I love these piano runs. It's absolutely fun to listen to, and also sad at the same time. I also really love Megustus too, I should probably mention that. Anyway, G-Friend made good songs. Next group is Girls' Generation. Catch Me If You Can is my least favorite. This is just annoying. What is this scent? The entire song is basically buzzing scent. I don't hate it, but it really gets on my nerves after a while. My favorite, I know this is gonna be a cop-out to call their debut my favorite song, but come on. Into the New World is such a classic. If I was gonna choose a second song, it would be The Boys, definitely, but this one is still amazing. And at the end of the day, I do prefer Into the New World to The Boys. This is such an anthemic song, just for all of K-pop, it's really hard for me to ignore that, and as much as I do think some of their other songs are good, nothing can really beat Into the New World in my opinion. Then we have GOT7, Girls, 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 That's the Worst. Going from a debut I love to a debut I can't stand. Maybe that's a bit harsh, but I don't like this at all. Out of BTS and GOT7, BTS definitely had the better debut, I'll say that much. But yeah, Girls, 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 they were going for this rough concept and it just didn't work out too well. The beat is slow, the song doesn't click for me. The best song is Not by the Moon, which is an absolute slow burn of a 2020 hit that I absolutely love the more I hear it. This isn't anything remarkably unique, but they sell it so well. It took it a while to grow on me, but it really has grown on me and I legitimately love the song now. Then we have Hwasa. Hwasa as a soloist literally only has two title tracks, and again, Twite is amazing. So calling it her worst makes me miserable and terrible inside. But I do really like Maria just a little bit more than Twite. They're both great though, so really no competition here. Then we have Hyo, and Dessert is my least favorite. I was only exposed to her solo work because of this song, and I don't even like it that much. It's really noisy. It's noisy and busy. I don't think it's terrible, but basically all I can say is I learned to tolerate this song. But Punk right now is fucking awesome. Even though I don't think you know what the definition of punk is, but I digress. But yeah, this beat is slaps. This is the type of thing I can see people not liking, but I love this type of song. What can I really say? Next we have Hyuna, with Ice Cream as my least favorite. I think this kind of goes without saying. It's definitely between this and Bubble Pop, but I do enjoy Bubble Pop. It's a pretty iconic song. Ice Cream is just considerably less fun than Bubble Pop. Favorite Hyuna song? I still don't care, it's still Red. As weird and bizarre as this song is, with the monkey butts and the twerking and the... I don't even know what the hell this song is. I love the way this sounds, what can I say? It's super catchy. Other songs that I like by her are definitely Hip and Lip and Babe, and I'm also a big fan of How's This, but yeah, Red is my favorite, by far. Next is Icon, my least favorite being Bling Bling. This song is just annoying. The ad-libs and the horns, it's just annoying. This is basically the male version of Kill This Love in terms of sound, and I don't like it. Then we have my favorite, which is Killing Me. Y'all were expecting me to say Love Scenario, weren't you? Well, I changed my mind, so Love Scenario is still great. But I decided I prefer Killing Me over Love Scenario. I changed my mind. Love Scenario is great, but Killing Me is such a unique song with a great vibe. This drop is weird AF, but I love it. I'm a sucker for angsty songs, what else can I say? Then we have ITZY. I really hate myself for putting Dolla Dolla as my least favorite anything, but here it is. Again, all three of their title tracks are great. It's really hard for me to decide if I prefer Dolla Dolla or ICY these days. I was really loyal to ICY, but then WANNABE became my favorite ITZY song, so what can I really say? And now I don't like ICY that much, I don't even know. But yeah, WANNABE is a fucking masterpiece. I think this will go down in history. And yes, I am excited for their song coming up, Not Shy, but I don't think it's gonna top this, let's be real. Then we have IU, and DBS my least favorite song. This definitely has an easy listening kind of vibe to it. I don't mind it, but it's far from good or anything I'm interested in. My favorite IU song is Blooming though. This is an absolute freaking bop. Now, I'll say there are other songs which are probably more meaningful or emotional, but Blooming is catchy, and I'm really not in an emotional state to listen to 8 again. Then we have IZ*ONE. I figured out how it's actually pronounced. It is pronounced IZ*ONE. So anyone who's been saying IZ*ONE, including me, is wrong. And I know a lot of people are really gonna hate me for putting this as my least favorite, but here we go. Again, I don't think this song is bad. I think it's a solid 6 out of 10. It's pretty mediocre. A lot of people really praise Olivia Rose, and in a year where it's as good as 2018, I just don't think the song is that amazing. It's catchy, I guess, but it never really stuck out to me. And as much as I do think Violetta is kind of a bop, and Secret Story of the Swarm is surprisingly good for a concept switch, my favorite title track from them is still Fiesta. This song was a slow burn for me. It took a while to grow on me. At one point it was in my top 10 of the year and then kind of just fell off. I don't like it as much as I used to, but this still slaps, honestly. Then we have J-Hope as a soloist. I didn't include RM because I didn't really know what counted as title tracks because of mixtapes. Same thing with August D. I know J-Hope is mixtapes, but I still thought I'd include it anyway. Because we need to talk about why does anyone actually like Chicken Noodle Soup? The song is bad. I can't. Then, of course, Daydream being the best. What can I really say? Then we have Mr. by Kara. Again, another song that I don't hate. It's pretty catchy, but it just isn't my favorite. Step is my favorite. Literally everyone loves the song. Even my dad likes this song. Again, not a huge Kara fan, but this song is great. Then we have Card. Dumb Liddy. Just need I say more. And I don't even hate the song because of the title or anything. I hate the song because it gives me a fucking headache. Yeah, really, this might genuinely be worse than Zim's album. And I hate Zim's album. Oh, did I spoil a pick for later on this list? Then we have Red Moon as my favorite. I also really like Bomb Bomb, but Red Moon is my favorite. I love the dark vibe of the song. It sounds really great. Then we have Luna with High High as my least favorite. It would have been Butterfly previously, but Butterfly actually grew on me, and now it's High High. I don't know, I just think that they're singing a little bit high high for my liking. It's a little bit high register from what I personally enjoy. I don't know, I'm sensitive to high noises. Then we have So What as my favorite, which is just a freaking bop. All that being said, I still don't think I'm a huge Luna fan, but this song did slap, so I'll give it that. I ranked it higher than Blackpink's song, so I'll give them credit for that. Then we have Mamamoo, another group that literally doesn't have bad title tracks. Mr. Ambiguous is my least favorite, again a debut. Either between Mr. Ambiguous or You're the Best, both songs are probably on the weaker tier of Mamamoo songs. But it's still really good, so I don't know what y'all are talking about. For best, it was impossible for me to choose. Literally, I was choosing between Go-Go BB, Hip, Starry Night, and Egotistic, but I ended up having to go with Egotistic in the end. Because this song absolutely slaps. What can I really say? It's amazing. This chorus is such a slow burn. This is one of the best songs of 2018, and considering how good of a year that was, I really have no more words. MCND. Apparently, they're having a comeback, and Spring is my least favorite. I don't like this song. I don't like the cheap-ass production and the shouting. Ice Age is my favorite, though. Not that I had much to pick from. unless I wanted to count Top Gang in this. But yeah, Ice Age honestly slaps. I think it took me a while to admit that this slaps, but it really does. Then we have Momoland, which thumbs up as my least favorite of their recent title tracks anyway. I haven't listened to their old title tracks, they're probably worse. I actually like Momoland's new song, and I actually enjoy Thumbs Up. It's not my favorite, but it's fine. It's serviceable. But between this, I'm So Hot, and Bam, I thought that I liked this the least. I actually enjoy I'm So Hot, surprisingly, and Bam is genuinely fun. The reason I mention those three songs in particular is because Boom Boom is still my favorite. What can I really say? The song works really well. I love everything going on in the production here. I love the dance. This is just a really great, unique little song. Unique at the time, it is. And then they made it again, but it's not even the horns that I like here. I mean, the horns are fine, but I like what's going on in the mix of the scent. It actually kind of gives me Russian Roulette vibes a little bit, musically. Maybe that's why I like the song so much. But yeah, I like Boom Boom a lot. Monsta X, least favorite Alligator. I think a lot of people would agree with me on this. I don't know, it's just kind of a busy song for me. I don't dislike it. I'm not a huge fan of Monsta X music, to be honest, and my other favorites going in were Hero and, the one song I literally cannot remember the name of right now. But Fantasia is still my favorite. This was a nice pleasant surprise when I heard this for the first time. Because, again, I'm not a huge fan of their music. Although Monsta X do seem to be genuinely great guys, so props to them. Then we have Nature. Some You'll Be Mine is my least favorite. This was their debut song. This is just very girl-crushy. Not even girl-crushy. Cutesy, in-your-face. I don't mind this at all. It's not something I'd usually listen to, though. And then they got a couple more songs, and then Girls is my favorite. This is their song from this year. And oh my god, I love it. I cannot believe they went from that type of concept to this. It's kind of like when CLC made Hobgoblin. But oh my god, the uncensored video for this song absolutely had me fucking shook. I did react to it, and oh my god. But yeah, this song is great. Then we have NCT 127, Simon Says is my least favorite. Y'all are probably expecting me to say Kick It as much as I've said I don't like Kick It, but at least Kick It has some semblance of fun. I don't like Simon Says. And by the way, the video ranking all the NCT, EXO, and SHINee title tracks is still coming. I've just been lazy. But yeah, Simon Says, weird voice warping. The song isn't fun. It doesn't really know what it is. Favorite song is Superhuman. Again, I guess these are slight spoilers for that list, but whatever. But yeah, Superhuman is genuinely a frickin' bop. I'm not the biggest fan of 127's music in general. Superhuman and Highway to Heaven are by far my favorite songs, mainly because this concept feels like it was originally meant for a different group, like SHINee and not NCT in the first place, but that doesn't mean I don't love it. Then we have NCT Dream, which I do like their music a bit more. We Go Up is my least favorite. The song is just kind of boring and doesn't really do anything for me. My favorite is Boom. I definitely had to choose between this and Raiden. As much as of a bop that Raiden is, I think Boom is a tighter song that I'll remember for longer. NCTU, Baby Don't Stop, easily my least favorite. What the hell is this beat? I don't like the whispering combined with a cheap-ass low beat. I tolerated a little bit more on Boss. It felt like Boss had a little more energy. This is an example of a song that feels like it's trying to be seductive and just comes off as creepy. I don't know. My favorite NCTU song is Without You. This is such a freaking bop, what else can I say? This song is an absolute freaking bop. Just amazing. Then we have Pentagon. Humph is my least favorite. It was close for me between Humph and SHINee, because I do not like either of these songs. But I don't know, Humph just is slightly more annoying to me. Favorite title track, Shalala. I've talked about not being the biggest Pentagon fan. I really like their song, Basket, but that one is for Kingdom, so it's not technically a title track. Also, which is why I didn't include Wanus on this list. Also, I do really like Dr. BB as well, but Shalala is the most catchy in my opinion. I really enjoy it. Next group is Pink Fantasy with Iruwa. Now, they literally only have 3 title tracks as well, and I like all of them. Itawa happened to be my least favorite here. I still like the song a lot, but it's kind of inferior to Fantasy in my opinion. Yeah, Fantasy is a Dreamcatcher clone, but it's a really fucking good one at that. And my favorite is Shadowplay, what can I say? This has become one of my favorite songs of the year. It's a blatant rip of Indian culture, but I like the way it sounds so much. This is just a genuine bop. And yes, I know it's technically a subunit, but they're being promoted under the group's name, so shut the fuck up. But yeah, everything about this song's production I love. I'm really surprised no one's crying cultural appropriation, though. Not that it's my place to judge, but like, I've seen much more minor things get screamed at for cultural appropriation, so what can I really say at this point? Next group is Red Velvet, and you probably expected this after what I said earlier. I'm not gonna go into depth here because I do plan to talk about this song more in depth in the future, but oh my god, I don't like it. I do not like Fanzalabim, I'm sorry. I have many, many reasons why. Mainly just the synth. That awful synth. The clanging percussion. The enunciation. There are so many reasons I don't like this song, but I could go on. Bad Boy has aged like fine wine, and it's legitimately one of my favorite K-pop songs. The girls sound fantastic on it. It was definitely a close call for me between this and Psycho, but I ended up still going with Bad Boy in the end. I will admit that Psycho does hit a bit harder, but Bad Boy just feels so like it's hard to ignore it. Next group is 17, Boom Boom is my least favorite. This song is just noisy. My favorite is Fear. I love when they make dark songs. Again, I do like some of their lighter, happier songs. I like Clap a lot, Very Nice, Left and Right. I even like Hit, but Fear is so fucking good, dude. This song is so intense. I love it. Then we have SF9. Good Guy is my least favorite. I don't like how repetitive the song is, and it just doesn't really do much for me. My favorite, though, is Summer Breeze. Oh my god, I love the way this sounds. It's super satisfying. Then we have Shiny. Error, error message, except, okay, it's actually Hello, let's be honest here. I feel like some asshole's gonna say Ring Ding Dong, but yeah, Hello. I think we all know this is the worst song. Can we just forget this happened, please, and move on? Okay, it's not that bad, come on. Favorite... Sherlock. Still Sherlock. I'm probably not changing my mind on this anytime soon, and again, spoilers for pretty much any future list where this song is mentioned, but yeah, what else can I really say? This song is a fucking masterpiece, and I will sing its praises until the end of time. Just... I don't have this as my favorite K-pop song for no reason, folks. SOMI, Birthday. The beat is just weird. I don't hate this. This is a solid 6 out of 10. And what you waiting for? Solid 7 out of 10. Really, neither of these songs really impressed me. But yeah. I think this one is a bit better. But it still kind of sounds cheap. I don't know what's going on and why the fuck SOMI decided to sign with YG, but okay. Then we have Stray Kids, Side Effects' least favorite. Actually kind of like parts of the song. Once that drop happens and they start screaming, it's too much. It's too much for my head. I don't mind the beat itself, but the weird screaming over it, my head can't deal with this. And we have my favorite, Mira. This rap kills me every time. And this drop is something really special. Yeah, I really love Levantar as well, but what can I say? Mira's a freaking bop. I don't think Easy was technically a title track. It's a subtitle track, you know, after God's Menu being the title track, but Easy might be my favorite Stray Kids song. It's definitely between Mira and Easy. I love both of them so much. I have no other words. Sunmi. Why doesn't this song have a chorus? Lalalei being Sunmi's worst song. Fact of the day that you probably didn't know already. Okay, no, but for real. This isn't even bad, it's just a solid 6 out of 10 again. My favorite song, hard choice, but Noir. I've gone back and forth on this before. I said Siren was my favorite at one point, but I think at the end of the day it is Noir. I'll admit that Poor People is edging its way up there, though. It might become my favorite before too long. I love how lush the instrumental in Poor People is. But Noir is a really tight song that fits really well to me. But I also do love Siren and Heroin as well. So yeah, Sunmi, Queen. Super Junior. Their most famous song is my least favorite. Yeah, Sorry Sorry is not for me. I'm sorry. Sorry. I'm also not a big Super Junior fan. I could go into that. I mean, Heechul was probably the only member who's in my good graces, and Yoonhook, or however the fuck you pronounce his name, is only in my good graces because he accepted Taemin's award and read the speech. Otherwise, I don't care about them, but I digress. So yeah. Yeah. I don't hate this song, but I don't like it either. It's basically Ring Ding Dong, but not fun, so let's just move on. Los Siento is my favorite, though. I don't know who this Leslie Grace girl is, but she's the best part of the song. Man, the shading Super Junior in this video. Then we have Tiara, a group I don't even like. And I don't even mind this part of the song, but the part where they repeat Bo Peep is my ears! Then we have Sugar Free as my favorite. What can I really say? This is still a catchy song, even if I'm not a huge fan of. And I always literally get these two groups mixed up all the time. Tiara and Kara. I don't know. And I probably get this song mixed up with Stub. Stub is the superior song, by the way. Then we have Taemin's solo music, and is there a worse song? Putting Press Your Number as the worst song makes me hate myself, but if Drip Drop was really a title track and had a video that wasn't a performance video, then I would say Drip Drop is the worst, but I absolutely adore Press Your Number. I just want to hear it as OT5 Shiny. If there's a demo of that somewhere, please fucking release it. Okay, seriously. But favorite, Want. It's still too early for me to form an opinion on 2Kids as of where it's gonna rank, but now, these are just his Korean title tracks. If we're counting Japanese title tracks, Flame of Love is the winner. But I digress. Then we have Taeyang, Ringalinga. This is just annoying. I don't hate it though. Then my favorite is Darling, because oh my god, this song hits hard. It would have been Eyes No Slips, and then I discovered Darling. And this song just makes me emotional. I don't know what else to say at this point. It's really good. What can I say? Then we have TXT. Cat and Dog is my least favorite. Big surprise there. Anyone who likes Crown less than Cat and Dog, what the fuck are you doing? And no, I don't hate this sound-wise or anything. I'm not gonna make fun of it for being a furry anthem or whatever the fuck. It's just really cheap sounding, what can I really say? Big surprise, Runaway is my favorite. I absolutely love Can't You See Me for the record, but Runaway fucking slaps so much. Runaway slaps so hard, it's legitimately an amazing song. This is literally one of the best K-pop songs I've heard, it's so great. Then we have Twice with Cheer Up as my least favorite. Definitely a hard call between this and Knock Knock. See, I think Knock Knock is the most boring song, the song that I just care the least about, but Cheer Up is by far the one that annoys me the most. I don't even mind the majority of the song, but this chorus can get stuck in my head all fucking day. And again, they're singing a bit of a high register that I'm not really a fan of. Just my personal taste. But yeah, I could have this on a fucking loop in my head for all day, and I'd rather not with this. My favorite is Likey. I know you can accuse me because this song is also repetitive as hell. But I love the production here. Also, I don't really mind having Likey, Likey, Likey stuck in my head as opposed to Chill Baby, Chill Baby. Yes. And the song is an actual chorus, so yeah. Other favorites include Fancy, What is Love, and Like Ooh Ah, but it had to go with Likey in the end. last group is 101, or second to last group anyway. Boomerang is my least favorite. I still kind of like the song. I don't really stand 101. Energetic is my favorite. This is an example of how you do a debut right. The song is just insanely catchy. I don't really know what else to say. Even my friend who doesn't like modern K-pop stands 101, so like, come on. Then we have Wavy. Take Off is my least favorite. I don't think any Wavy songs are bad. I actually think Wavy have a better track record than most of the other NCT units in terms of making good songs. But this is a good solid 7 out of 10. Favorite, Turn Back Time, big surprise here. Every time I've talked about this song, posted it in any ranking just ever. This is my favorite song of the year, no doubt, and I literally put it at number 12 on my favorite K-pop songs of all time, which I will be redoing as a 500. But yeah, no, really, Turn Back Time is a masterpiece. I will admit that I really love Moonwalk, but Turn Back Time just had that soul for me. Then we have Wakimeki. I forgot how many W groups I had. And Picky Picky is my least favorite. I know a lot of people are gonna hate me for this, and I'll admit that I don't like Your Girlfriend has some really clunky verses, but the chorus is super catchy. And Picky Picky is just, again, one of those high-pitched songs I'm not really a big fan of. Favorite? It used to be Dazzle Dazzle, but now it's Crush. I changed my mind on that one. This chorus is amazing. What else can I say? Now we have Wonder Girls. I don't want to say Nobody is my least favorite because I've barely heard any of their songs, but out of all of them, this one's just really basic. Then we have Be My Baby as my favorite. This is just much more lively and fun in comparison. I love the retro throwbacks these Wonder Girls, you know, have. And I really should give them more of a chance. Then we have Winner as the actual last group. Every Day is my least favorite. It's between Every Day and So-So. Winner's another group I just don't like their music that much. It's like about Pentagon, but... And then we have Really Really as my favorite. Because regardless of what I want to whine about Tropical House all I want, Really Really is still freaking bop. And at least I'll take this over whatever Justin Bieber was putting out at the time. Yeah, so that's the list. Honestly, just pretty decent overall. I didn't really hate most of those songs. I can think of like two of the songs that I actually hated, which was Dumb Lydia and Zamzalabim, but yeah. Anyway, guys, like for more content. I'll see you all next time. Bye!